Adobe Premiere April 2018. Hey, what's up guys, welcome to my YouTube channel Digital Creations, and today in this tutorial we are going to learn top new features of Adobe Premiere Pro CC 2018 April update version 12.1. So let's get started. Open Adobe Creative Cloud application, and guys, you see there the update of Premiere Pro CC, but I already update this software. You just update this software, and now guys, you also switch the previous version of Premiere Pro CC very easily. There is an option in this application, Adobe Creative Cloud split view of screen. Our program monitor easily. Just split our program monitor display horizontally, vertically, or view full images side by side, and we can compare an image before and after color grading. Another new feature is the shot comparison and color matching. So we can compare the looks of two different shots across a sequence of shots and match colors while retaining skin tones with a single click. All changes made are visible and accessible to the other user, and can be manipulated further if necessary. So now guys, there is also a face detection feature is also available in this new feature. Another very good feature of Adobe Premiere Pro CC April 2018, the motion graphics templates, a better browsing and managing experience, lets we search and preview motion graphics templates from our local templates folder, Creative Cloud libraries, or Adobe stock right in the essential graphics panel. So to quickly find the templates we need. So now guys, here you see in Adobe stock there's options available. Here we find the free motion graphics templates and the premium. So where we can buy the motion graphics templates from Adobe stock. Now guys, very easily we can preview the motion graphics template. Just right click on the template, the preview, where the we find the info, and we can purchase this premium. And if you click the free checkbox, so we search the free motion graphics template. No need to change anything. You just drag and drop free templates and use it. It is customizable.
premiumbeat.com.
Another great feature is the gradient support for shapes and text layers. And under the graphic workspace in a central graphics panel, we can create more visually interesting graphics using that gradients. So we just click any shape, color, swatch in the central graphics panel, then choose from a solid. We have there are options available there, linear gradient or radial gradient. Fill types, we can edit the angle of this gradient color and the color spot, midpoint directly from the program monitor. Now guys, we can toggle animation for graphic layers and the essential graphics panel. It's a very good option. Animate more quickly with the ability to toggle on animation for position, rotation, anchor point, scale, and opacity by clicking their icons in the essential graphics panel and then adjusting the property in the panel or by editing the graphic layer directly in the program monitor. So we can move the playhead changes the property or recorded as keyframes. Guys, a better way of working with the motion graphic templates is an improved interface and new controls make it easier to customize motion graphics templates created in After Effects, including adjusting the 2D position, rotation, and scale of elements. Edit text layers of the graphic by clicking on them in the program monitor. So before now guys, we use another option in After Effects when we create a motion graphic templates for scale and then transformation tool. But here now in this latest update, April 2018, we can drag and drop these transformation tool easily. Thank you. we can replace clip for motion graphics templates, easily replace a template in a timeline with an updated version from After Effects. Simply hold the Alt key on the keyboard and Option in the Mac, plus drag and drop the new replacement template onto an existing one. So we can choose to have the template updated everywhere. It is used as a project or limit to one instance where possible customization will be preserved. Another new feature is auto-duct music. The volume of a music can be set automatically lower when dialogue, sound effects, or other audio clips are detected, eliminating the need to manually adjust every point in the mix.
We just select this audio clip, then go to dialogue, and here the option is auto-match. Then select the music and go to music, and here just select the auto match option, and here we find the ducking option. So now guys, if we look at here, we generate the keyframes. It automatically generate the keyframes and lower down the voice.
Another new feature is auto duck music. The volume of a music can be set automatically lower when dialogue, sound effects, or other audio clips are detected, eliminating the need to manually adjust every point in the mix.